was there? Get away.
Turn on that light, for God's sake.
I am. It's just over here. There we go. It's only me.
Who are you?
He owns the bed you're sleeping in. That's who he is.
My name is Tony. I'm in charge of this place. The Rosefield Hotel. I hope it didn't scare you. It's just that Detective Harris here arrived, and he wants to ask you some questions.
Oh, please, sir. You must help me.
Now look, listen to me. I'm here to find out how you got into this country, and that's all right. If you want help, go to the Department of Justice. There are no bloody chairs in this place, no?
Oh, there are none about. I'll have a look downstairs.
Now look, I'm sorry about that. But you must realise, my function is to investigate how you got into this country. There are people here that are paid to help asylum seekers like yourself. But I'm not one of them. Of course, the real problem is, if you want to see any help at all, you got to get past me. Right then. Name, please.
Fatima Youssef.
Can you spell Youssef?
Y-U-S-S-E-F-F.
There we go. Can I get either something to drink, maybe?
No, thank you. I don't drink anymore.
Well, I mean, what about tea or coffee? Either of you? Fatima? Sure, it's no trouble. A couple will warm you up.
Well, okay.
Which will it be, then?
Tea, please.
No, I'll have a coffee, but not instant. Anything but instant.
I think instant's all we have, but we can check for you.
Ah, well, if you only got Nescafe or some French crap like that. I'll stay as I am, thanks. Right, so, it's Miss Youssef.
Yes, sir.
And how old are you, Miss Youssef?
28.
And do you work?
Yes, I do. I work as a nurse in the Freetown Hospital. Do you mind, sir, if I put on a jumper? It's quite cold in here.
Bloody freezing in here. Right, so, Miss Youssef, you arrived here at the Rosefield last night. Is that correct?
Yes, sir.
How many hours did you get here?
I came in a taxi, sir.
Taxi? Why did you ask the taxi to come to this particular hotel?
I didn't ask the taxi man. Only the driver knew where to take me.
The driver? So you're saying somebody ordered the taxi for you?
Well, somebody must have.
Who?
I don't know. I wasn't even expecting a taxi.
Can you describe the taxi, please?
No, I can't remember. But there was a taxi driver, and another man came with him.
Can you describe them?
No, I can't. I was sitting behind them in the taxi. We drove for a very long time.
How long would you say you were driving for?
I don't know. It felt like forever.
Ah, come on, think. What are we talking about? Hours? Minutes? What?
It was dark. I was scared.
Look, either you're not thinking hard enough, or you're hiding something from me.
No, I'm not.
Fine. So you didn't know any of the men or the person who ordered the taxi for you?
Sir, I didn't ask for a taxi. I simply asked to leave my country.
And where exactly is your country?
Sierra Leone.
Sierra Leone.
Yes, sir. On the way, something terrible happened.
I'm still writing my book. Now, can you tell me what part of Sierra Leone you're from?
A small town called Kissy, just outside Freetown.
Freetown? You know, I was in Sierra Leone once. It's a lovely place.
No, it's not. There's a civil war going on at the moment. Perhaps you were there when there was...
Yes, perhaps. Well, maybe you'd like to tell me just what it's like now. It's been a while.
There's not a living soul in Sierra Leone that doesn't fear for their lives. I don't think you'd like it.
Have you ever been to London, Miss Youssef?
No, I haven't.
Hang on, I'll phrase that differently. Have you ever been anywhere in Europe, perhaps?
This is my first time out of Sierra Leone.
You know, Miss Youssef, working for the Irish Police Force, I'm involved on a day-to-day basis with immigrants, like yourself.
Now let me put you in the picture as regards Ireland's refugee crisis at the moment. There are about 40,000 classified refugees living in this country. And I reckon 10,000 of them are here illegally. And it's those people that are making my job and my life very uncomfortable. 10,000, remember that. It means in the last 3 months, I've seen more fake passports, fake documents, and fake identification to last me a lifetime. Now, 2 nights ago, Saturday night, I was up until 5 o'clock on a Sunday morning, dealing with 2 so-called Romanian refugees, both of whom turned out to have addresses in London. Now, that really pisses me off. It's people like them that get a pretty messy time over here. Not only from me, but from the Mount Street Refugee Centre, Department of Justice, and not to mention the thousands of refugee haters living in Dublin.
Sir, I've lived nowhere other than Sierra Leone all my life.
Well then, you must have some form of proof of citizenship. May I see it?
I cannot afford a passport.
Do you have any, just yes or no?
No.
Fine.
Oh, please, sir. I'm sorry. I'm so desperate. Please listen to me.
Get your hands off me. What right do you have coming over here and grabbing me? I could walk out that door at any moment and leave you here with nothing.
Sir, I've lost my daughter by coming here. I'm not an illegal immigrant. All I'm asking is for you to help me find the man who got rid of my baby. Please, sir. I'm begging you. On the boat, you see.
Get up.
Thank you. On the boat, you see. I paid some sailors to get Hassan Asher, my daughter, and myself out of Sierra Leone. On the way here, Hassan Asher died. The sailors took her body, and I never saw her again.
Can you tell me your first name again, please?
Hassan Asher.
Hassan Asher Youssef?
Yes, sir.
And how old was your daughter, Miss Youssef?
She was 16 months old. I think her body was thrown overboard.
Hold on. That's a pretty strong allegation you're making. What makes you think that?
Well, sailors don't want a dead body on their boat. It was a cargo boat, you see.
Cargo?
Yes. It was a container ship. We were kept in the cargo hold. It wasn't easy for Hassan Asher. She was very ill before we left Sierra Leone.
How long were you on the ship for?
I don't know. It was dark. It was a Sunday night when we left.
Well, today's Monday, the 13th of December. You can't just say that in a day. I reckon 8 days sounds about right.
Yes.
And can you remember the name of the ship?
No, I can't.
I still think you got a very suspicious memory, Miss Youssef. Do you know that? Come on, what was it like? Any particular features?
Well, it was rusty.
Good, go on.
It was rusty brown. It was not a very big boat. It was an old boat. It had a very loud engine.
And can you remember anything about the crew?
The men I met were all from Sierra Leone. They were tall, strong, young men. One of the men was wearing a Christian cross on his neck.
How come you can remember a Christian cross and not the bloody ship's name?
Well, you see, it's just like the one I'm wearing.
Lovely.
Wait now. How did the sailors find your daughter if you were locked in a container?
We weren't locked, sir. They brought food to us every day. On the day that Hassan Asher died, it was very warm in the container. It was hard to breathe. She was coughing and crying very loudly. 2 sailors heard and came in. I asked them for a glass of water, but before they returned, Hassanetta had died. She had just rolled her eyes and released her last breath.
Miss Youssef, if what you're saying is true, then you must be prepared to tell the Department of Justice what you've just told me. I can arrange for a meeting with them, and all going well, you can find out exactly what happened to your daughter.
Sir, I don't think you'd be able to find the sailors.
Miss Youssef, I'm a very powerful man. You'd be surprised what I could do.
I hope so. I put my trust in you.
Good. I'm glad you can identify genius up close. You know, Mr. Seth, my job really isn't as easy as it seems. I've been kicked, stabbed, bottled, shot at. Of course, in retaliation, I've given the criminals exactly what they've given me. Kicks, stabs, shots, the lot.
You shot a man?
In the course of duty, yes. But don't be so shocked. I'm sure if you knew the circumstances, you'd be a little more sympathetic.
I'm not shocked. You're not the first murderer I've met.
Look here. You were doing fine up until that. I'm a bloody detective, for God's sake. I'm given a gun for protection.
Now, that should warm you up.
Thank you kindly.
There was only Nescafe downstairs. Sorry.
It's yourself for me to stay here over Christmas. You have the necessary contacts and documents to make that arrangement possible?
Oh, I will. What happened to you when we asked him?
Now, correct me if I'm wrong. But you paid sailors to take yourself and your daughter out of Sierra Leone. And then en route to Ireland, she died and was subsequently thrown overboard.
Oh, good God. How old is she?
16 months.
That's terrible. I'm so sorry. You know, I lost a daughter as well. Last Christmas. Gemma was her name. She wasn't even a year old. A cot death. So the doctor said. You know, her arm is still around the Pink Panther Teddy. Her nanny had bought her. I'll never forget the funeral. I really am so, so sorry. What was wrong with her?
I don't know why God took her away from me. She had a fever before we left Sierra Leone. On the way here, she got worse.
Stuffed in the back of a container ship wouldn't earn much good either.
You were stuffed in a container?
Well, we didn't ask for much. We just...
Come on now. Miss Youssef needs to get some rest. And I need to make some phone calls. You can show me where the phones are.
Oh, I will. Call me if you need anything, right?
Need anything? Well, a bloody heater would help. And how about a decent bloody chair? Fell off the back of a skip, did it?
What's wrong with the chair?
Come on, turn off that light there. Listen to me. I don't know if the Eastern Health Board can label this place Assange boarding as for refugees. It doesn't even meet UN humanitarian standards. The cloth in the bed itself. It's rat's piss they're living in. And Tony, let's just start cleaning this place. Oh, not your bloody heart, but I make myself clear.
Detective Harris, when was that the Shelburne?
The Shelburne. I'm glad you still got one sense unimpaired.
But look, the refugee scheme is all that keeps this place open and keeps me in the job.
The refugee scheme. £65 a week per room per refugee. Taxpayers' money, paid through the Eastern Health Board.
Well, look, I only signed up in the first place because no one was using it. It was just the bar, the junk's in the bar. Sure, the rooms weren't being used for 11 months of the year.
Sure, the 1 month we did have business people waste their money. I mean, look at that bed. I wouldn't sleep in that unless you paid me. Or put Pamela Anderson in it, you know.
What's wrong with the bed?
What's wrong with the bed? Well, you may notice it's a little shorter than the occupant. And feet tend to be partial numbness, especially with Christmas 1 week away. Now, that's a substandard bed. You've also got faulty electricity, sir, because I'm no heating. Come on, Tony, sort yourself out.
It's just not that easy.
Well, look, I'll put it to you this way. If I was dumped in Sarah Dawn tomorrow, and given a hall with no air conditioning, yet live electricity wires, I'd piss my pants laughing, knowing the feckin' Irish Army to invade the place. Do you understand?
Yeah.
Good. Now lead the way.
Don't touch. Get your hand away. You have to know how to do it properly. You could get a bad shock. Pardon me, my name is Nikov Veretinikov. I live right beside you. That wall separates our rooms. I heard you come in last night. It was quite late. Pardon me, I don't even know your name.
My name?
Yes.
My name is Fatima.
Pleased to meet you, Fatima. I hope you were not sleeping. I'm sorry if you were.
No, I wasn't. I can't at the moment.
Yes. Your daughter. I heard a little. Through the wall, you see.
Why were you listening to the conversation?
I was not listening. I was simply reading the newspaper, but I cannot help hearing what I hear. These walls are paper thin. You seem in a pretty poor state at the moment. I have some money. It's not much.
No. Thank you kindly. I'm sure I'll be able to manage. The man who owns this hotel seems to be able to help me.
Ha. Yes. Tony. Perhaps he will even put up some Christmas decorations. I don't know. Well, if you are tired and wish to rest, I shall disappear. I simply wanted you to know who I am, where I am, and how crazy I am.
No, would you like to stay?
Of course I would. I've already read the paper. Now, tell me, I am from Russia, but you are from Sierra Leone, yes. Tell me about this mysterious country. I confess, I know nothing.
You know nothing? But you obviously read the papers.
Yes, as much as possible.
Well,
but
it must say something.
These are Irish newspapers. I'm not so sure.
Every newspaper should say something about Sierra Leone. It should be called the Forbidden Land. For the devil himself has led our people astray. There's a civil war going on at the moment. On the streets where I live, the streets where I shop, the streets where I grew up in as a child, thousands of people have died at the hands of the rebel forces. Last January, my husband, Ibrahim, was killed in Freetown. I was with him. We were seeking shelter in the Rockwelland Church. Three rebels came in and started shooting. Ibrahim ran towards the door. A young boy with a rifle shot him. Hassanat had left the war. We thought we'd survive. But Hassan Asher had died coming here.
I'm sorry. I see you believe in the Bible. I read the Bible when I first came here. Part of it, anyway. Maybe I shouldn't have. I'm a Jew, you know.
The Bible tells us of Jesus the refugee, just like us. I feel so strange being called a refugee, you know. Jesus was a refugee in Egypt before Herod ordered his killing. Here we are, Matthew chapter 2. Joseph got up in the middle of the night took the child and his mother and left for Egypt.
During the night? Herod didn't give him much time to get out, did he?
Ah, yes, but Jesus was welcome in Egypt.
Ah, there, you see. We weren't welcome, were we?
Well, my welcome was very strange.
I don't know. I do know there are a lot of racist people in Ireland. I came here because I was promised freedom. I was promised a lot of things which I have yet to see. I don't think I'll stay here much longer. I'm not allowed to work here. I'm not even allowed to live here.
Where would you go?
I don't know. Probably back to England. I have a friend there. She could take care of me for a couple of weeks, and then I don't know. I'm not going back to Russia.
Why not?
It wasn't nice. I don't like talking about it. There was no war going on, but it was not a nice place. Come now. We must stop talking so sad and melancholy. It's not right. You know, I used to be a singer once. Shall I sing you a song?
Yolushka vervilush radilesh. Yolushka.
What am I doing wrong?
Nothing, I'm sorry.
No, I shall stop singing.
Instead, I shall dance. I need a partner.
Oh, I think I'll stay in bed.
You cannot stay in bed all day, it's not right.
Come on, we're strangers in a foreign land, so let's be strange.
I don't think I can dance.
A great man in my country once said, to be truly great, we must work together. So come on, take my hand.
Come on, take my hand. Come on, take it hard. You need to do it properly, come on. Now around.
Social worker there. The meeting will be on 2 o'clock on Monday the 10th of January 2000.
They can't take you over Christmas. I've also contacted Crumlin Garda Station about that taxi you were in last night. They'll put out an appeal for the taxi man to come forward. And Detective Cronin in Rafarnham will make inquiries at port authorities in Waterford, Larne, Rosslare and Cork to find out if any cargo container ships have arrived directly from Sierra Leone. Until then, you can unpack your bags. You'll be staying here over Christmas. Tony here will look after you.
You'll be all right here.
Well, that's debatable. You might want to go back home after this place. What can I say? Okay, beautiful. What?